Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play Lunar. Eternal Blue. Blind. There's only a couple guards in here that say new things, so... in the interest of speeding things along and not being boring... well, now that we've got everyone with us... that would be smart. Oh! And I want to see... let me just see. Does Hiro have room? He has room for one. It's gotta be one of the girls who have this, these white dragon wings. Can't equip. Okay. Let's give it to Hiro. See if he can equip it. Nope, can't equip. There's your answer. Lunar Bob, there's your answer. You can't equip. Move back to Jean. She has the most room. So we're good here. Here's Marvin. I like this little kitty a lot. Can I keep her? I'll feed her fishies every day. It's been real swell eating all your fish, but I'm not going to be your pet. Duh. Well, why not, pretty kitty? Hiro says, hee, yeah, Ruby, why not? Hiro, don't even joke about leaving me with this thing. Hey, kitty, did you come back to be my special friend? No. Just checking to make sure I hadn't dreamt at all. I didn't. Bye. Meh. Okay. The rest of these guys don't say anything new. Just over here. I don't remember. It's these guys down here. I told you we'd get here in no time flat. The Destiny is the fastest ship around. Let's see. Say there, you look a little blue. Are you feeling okay? Ruby says, I think it's called seasickness. It's okay as long as I keep flying, but when I land, look out below. Some adventurers, huh? Hmm. So that's worth going back and seeing. We can get into his chamber, we can't do anything. Oh, I didn't mean to go here. Go back around. I'm gonna check this other area. I haven't been in here since we came back to the ship. Legends of Lore, Volume 4, Dragon Master Dying. Navigational Blunders, Volume 2, Creative Cannibalism. Managing Seasickness, Volume 1. Erp, there it is. This area is empty. Yeah. Alright, we're done. Oops. Pentagulia, here we come. I will do my best to secure an audience with Althina, Neo says. However, I cannot promise you I will succeed. Oops. Oh no, Lucia says. Galleon.
Welcome to Pentagulia.
Thanks.
I'm impressed with your cunning and resolve.
Oh, I thank you.
Unfortunately, the sands have nearly run from the hourglass.
Huh? What are you talking about, hourglass? Lucia says, how is it that you have come to this holy city? Athena's power should have prevented this. Leo says, ah, Master Galleon, this is an unexpected pleasure. Huh? Master Galleon? You mean to say that he is welcome here? Athena has sanctioned your actions? Master Galleon, I was ordered to bring Lucia to justice. What? I have brought her to Pentagulia so that Athena may decide her fate. Ah, Galleon says, but I know all that. For you see, at Athena's behest, I have been following Lucia's progress. Following? I have noticed that your dedication to the goddess has become, questionable. How can you say that? I have done everything asked of me by the goddess. Ah, yes. Well then, I'm sure you do your best to take the girl to the goddess. And then the real show will begin. Leo says, this is very strange. I must find out what's going on before you arrive. Something is terribly wrong. Ruby says, Leo, wait. Where are you going? How are we supposed to find Athena's sanctuary? Follow that dude? Oh, wait. These guys are staying here? Lumina says, I guess I'd better be taking off, too. I've got to have a few words with that creep Borgen. If you do happen to see the goddess, would you ask her if she would like to donate some money or luck to the guild? After all, she was the one that destroyed Vayne in the first place. I really would blame that on Galleon. Lucia says, but wasn't she under Master Galleon's control? Yeah. Okay, she was under Galleon's control. Same diff. Point is, it'd be nice if she helped rebuild it. Anyway, whether you get to the god goods or not, you have to come back to Vayne. I want you in my magic guild for mega sure. But Lumina, I don't think that would be possible. You see... Yes, don't worry. We'll figure something out, Lucia. Anyway, I better go. Wish me luck. Where are you going? Into the city? Isn't that where we're going? So why are we all not going separately? Jean says, I have to go and see Master Lun now. Maybe he can shed some light on my encounter with the Blue Dragon cult leader. I must find out who he really is. I'm going to miss all of you very much. Once you've finished everything, come to the carnival and see me again. Ruby says, okay. I just can't wait to see you dance again. When you come, Ruby, I'll do a special dance for you. Jeez, everyone's deserting us. Ronfar? Well, this is the end of my bargain, too. I saw you through to Pentagulia. Now I've got some business of my own. Don't worry, Leo will see to it that you find the goddess. I've got to go see Mari. Hate to say it, but goodbye, Hiro. Goodbye, Lucia. Ruby says, how rude. Aren't you going to say goodbye to me, too? Ha ha ha. Oh, yes. How could I forget? Goodbye, Ruby. Make sure you keep a rein on that fire of yours. I'll save all my fire for you. Don't ever change, Squirt. I guess this is adios. I sure hope Ronfar knows what he's doing. I think that girl is bad news. Lucia says, I don't think I've ever felt feelings like this before. It's as if there's a deep hole inside me. Lucia, everyone has that feeling when someone you care about leaves. It's called loneliness, or even sadness. So, this hole in my heart, this empty space, is sadness? Then, yes, I feel sad that everyone has left. Oh well, what are you gonna do? These look like ladders or something. Can we go, like, that way? No. Alright, there's nothing on this side. Just looking for, like, chests and fun stuff. Sorry about that. My friggin' disc defragmenter that I always forget about. Peoples. Water. Oh wow. Okay. Bonky bonky bonk. Bonk. Wow. Ruby says, Hiro, look at this place. It's fantastic. Althina must be nearby, but I do not yet sense her presence. It's so strange. Hopefully it is not too late to stop Zophar and save both our worlds. But that means...
Means what?
You never finish what you're talking about. We have been selected by the goddess to administer her teachings to this world. Althina has chosen us from amongst many, and we all take this responsibility very seriously. Well, I'm very impressed. The only thing that keeps me going is to hope that one day, if I'm good enough, she will bless my work and grant me immortality. Okay. Only the most holy priests are allowed within the confines of Pentagulia, although Athena sometimes makes allowances for those that donate large sums. What? Me? Yes, I am a priest. But it was not always so. In my former life, I was but a simple merchant. I was allowed to enter Pentagulia only after I made a sizable donation. Althina is not supposed to be interested in the wealth of humans. However, the priests here have taught me differently. I guess they're frauds. They have shown me the light. Hi. The tower before you was constructed in honor of Red Priest Mari. Okay, so we got this tower. Got this place. Althina comes to our world as a human only once in a great while. I am fortunate that she has come during my lifetime. Will you lay down your life for the goddess Althina? Someday it may be asked of you. I don't know about that. This is the entrance to the Black Tower. It was constructed in honor of Grand Black Wizard Borgen. We hate it when he comes to Pentagulia to inspect his tower, because we have to grease the doorframe to get him inside. Oh my god. The guy's a fat pig. No two ways about it. Okay, so we got these different towers, and we got these other entrances. Check out this place, whatever this is. Oh boy! A bunch of people here. I haven't seen you before, so tell me, when did you get in? How long do you plan on staying in our city? Did you bring everything that you need? Is there anything I can do for you? Ruby says, yeah, you can shut up for a brief second and let me get a word in edgewise. Back so soon? Tell me, how long do you plan to stay this time? We haven't left. I'm sick and tired of listening to people say how great Galleon is. Don't these people remember that he once tried to destroy our world? Exactly. That's what I'm saying. With all the monsters present in this world, it's a good thing that the goddess had the Dragon Master and the four heroes. Could you imagine a world without the protection they give us? I'm starting an anti-Galleon campaign. I think we're talking to that other girl, though. We'll focus our attention on trying to get Galleon out of the holy city of Pentagulia. I think it's great that the four heroes are fighting hard to restore peace. It just makes you kind of proud to be alive. Alright, let's talk to her last, for whatever reason I feel like doing that. I'm sorry, but I can't stand to be amongst ones who have no love for the goddess. They have no direction in their lives, nor any respect for the elderly. I tell you, if everyone worshipped Althina, this would be a better world. Since I've found the goddess, I don't fear death anymore. Hold on. Itch. Itch on ear. Okay. Just being able to live in this city is worth 1,000 lives. It's an interesting way of putting things. I think that the goddess should build a new city. Pentagulia is getting that last week sort of feel to it lately. It used to be so nice here, but then they started letting common trash in. And that was it. There went the cachet. Oh, I hear that the goddess isn't going to build a new city. Now I'm really pissed. Well, we found out that news fast. I heard that long ago Galleon was despised by the inhabitants of Lunar. I don't understand that. Because he tried to rule the world, destroy the world. Galleon is so strong, he looks so fine. I think he's just the dreamiest man that ever walked the face of Lunar. Ruby says, I'm thinking just two words. Hard. Up. Do you think a gal like me and a guy like Galleon can ever get together? Yeah, but what would you have? I don't even want to think about it. Blech. What would you have? Oh, like offspring? Did you hear that the destroyer is here inside Pentagulia? I hope Master Galleon kills it before it gets close to Althena. She's standing right there. I can't believe that the destroyer walks free in our city. Won't anyone stop it? Nope. Check out this building. I've not known sadness in all the time I've lived here. I think it's because the goddess has blessed me. Ruby says more like it's because of the Prozac injections they give you at dinner. I'm sorry, but I can't speak to people who don't appreciate the goddess. I appreciate the goddess, you stupid wench. Ruby. You know, it is always good manners to thank the goddess for all she's done. It teaches you to be humble in this degenerate world. Yeah, as if. Remember, always give thanks to the goddess. And donate all your worldly wealth. It's hard for me to imagine that this world was once a desolate waste. Just think, if Althena didn't care about us, the world would still be desolate. Let me in. We have the best soldiers in the world stationed here. Many say there's no way that Zophar will ever return fully to this dimension. Lucia says, but the power of Zophar is getting stronger by the minute. You don't know what you're facing. Even though the goddess was reborn into this world, she still relies on the power of the Dragon Master for protection. Althena does not need the power of humans, Lucia says. Her power is the only way to stop Zophar. I hope that Althena has enough power to kill Zophar. As a member of the Althena cult, we are sworn to keep the good name of Althena free from reproach. That's why our manners are always impeccable. Woo! All the time? That would suck. As a true believer, I will not bring any reproach on the name of Althena. And you will not attract any women. Now these are not doors, right? They're windows. The best way to ensure your safety while you're here is to donate to the goddess. The goddess's love embraces those that give freely. What interest does Althena have in money? Galleon has completely changed his ways. He lives only to ensure that the goddess stays free from harm. I think I've always been lucky. Since I've joined the cult, look at all the good things I've received. You know, it pays to worship the goddess Althena. Yeah, we know. Don't leave home without her. I had to leave behind most of my family to get here, but at least I'm happy. Down in here. For some reason I want to check those towers last. see that. How dare you bring this filthy animal into our holy city? Its presence will not be tolerated. I am not an animal. I'm a red dragon, idiot. Mari does not serve pathetic little cats with delusions of grandeur. When she finds out what you're saying, she'll kill you. Oh yeah? Well, I got something to say about that. Bite me. Awesome. Gotta love Ruby. This is the holy sanctuary where the goddess resides. If you do anything to upset the goddess, she'll destroy you in a flash. Okay, I'll keep that in mind. I've been in Pentagulia all this time and I've never seen the goddess. I just hope I can get one glimpse of her before I die. I have never seen one bring such a fantastic gift before the goddess. Are you going to sacrifice the flying cat in exchange for her favor? You guys are really pissing Ruby off. I think someone's already sacrificed your brain. What do you think we are, stupid? I believe that Althina will find pleasure in the cat you brought to sacrifice. You wouldn't consider selling it to me, would you? Stop laughing, Hiro. This is serious. This moron wants to kill me. It's not a laughing matter. I think it is. You talk to him? The thought that the goddess herself resides here sends chills down my spine. This place sends chills down my spine, too. But I think it's because this joint's so spooky. I mean, listen to that music. Where the hell is that coming from? Do they pipe it in? I mean, I'm just waiting for Lon Chaney to pop up at any minute. Creepy. Awesome. Look towards the heavens and bask in the glow of Goddess Althina's love. Only then will you know true happiness. We have been selected by the goddess to administer her teachings to this world. Althina has chosen us from amongst many, and we all take this responsibility very seriously. The only thing that keeps me going is the hope that one day, if I'm good enough, she'll bust my work and grant me immortality. We've talked to him. Okay, so we've got these two towers, and we've got that place. It's the where the goddess herself resides. We all could learn much from the goddess Althina. Her love has spread even to Galleon, who once enslaved her. Now he walks freely about her great city. Is there no end to her love? Or her stupidity. It's amazing that Althina allows Galleon to be here. You know, once before, he even tried to kill her beloved dragon master. Ruby says, why would she even risk that? Isn't Galleon pure evil? So here's another tower. I have been assigned to stand guard over this tower by Master Len. The tower was erected in his honor. Oh, holy musics. I haven't seen you before. Are you new here? Goddess Althina must be very fond of you, for only the most holy are allowed in. I think Althina has the right idea in keeping the riffraff out. Thank Althina, there is no concept of civil liberties in Lunar. This tower is constructed in honor of White Knight Leo. Well, let's go in one of these. Bunch of guards. Some statues. Lord Leo is relentless when he has been given an assignment. We will not rest until he has seen it through to completion. And heaven help the poor soul that gets in his way. Ruby says, we sort of had a first-hand demonstration of that already. I really need a vacation. I've been working day and night helping Leo for what seems like forever. His passion for his work is going to be the end of me. Leo demands perfect service from his loyal servants, and I, for one, will not let him down. I'm sorry, but this room is off limits to commoners. You cannot enter this room without Lord Leo's direct order. I really don't have the mental fortitude to understand what's going on. But I guess that's how Lord Leo likes it. He only enlisted me because I'm an awesome swordsman. Since I've been fighting alongside Leo, we've never lost a battle. In fact, I kind of have this superstition. As long as we're winning, I don't take a bath. Ugh. So, I guess we can't go in here. Oh, great. Ruby says, the door's locked. Maybe there's another way in. There's another way in? Sorry about that. I hit the left arrow and it put me inside. Maybe a secret entrance? A secret entrance? Nope. Alright, let's check this other tower. So which one's this? Master Lun. Looks familiar. Oh, Jean's in there. Many of the priests say they're interested in Master Lun's honesty. I think they're interested in the taxes he collects for the goddess. Lun sure has an impressive physique up close. Lun uses us merely as sparring partners while he's here in Pentagulia. Just between you and me? I'm tired of being a punching bag. If this is what I've got to do to be a member of Lun's karate team, I'm gonna quit. I'm beginning to think that Lun likes beating up poor, weak slobs like myself. He gets some kind of perverse pleasure out of it. Sounds fun, really. Years ago, Lun was trying to develop a new type of martial art. Yet, he lost interest when once he became one of the four heroes. I wonder what kind of fighting technique he was going to invent. Lun says to be truly effective during combat, one must know everything about their enemy. If you learn your enemy's weaknesses, you can attack them mercilessly. Master Lun is a very busy man. No one ever gets to spend more than 5 minutes talking to him. It's such a shame. That poor man never gets any rest. With all the traveling that Lun does, he's earned enough frequent sailing miles to travel the world over 10 times. Okay, that was a typo, I guess. I wonder if he'll let me use them. You see that? Enough frequent sailing miles to the travel world. Yep. Okay, can we go in here? I guess we're listening at the door. Ah, it's been some time since our last encounter, Jean. What brings you all the way to Pentagulia? It's this mask. I took it from the leader of the Blue Dragon cult. Hey, no way. Hiro had that mask. But what good is this mask? Didn't you get a look at the leader? No, he covered his face before I could get a look at it. He was in such a hurry to get away, though, that he dropped the mask. His voice seems so very familiar, but I can't put my finger on it. Okay, that's it. Check out these other towers. We got two left. Well, oh, I hate that. Okay. Crime. We can't go that way. Start bashing ourselves into the wall. Which one? The Black Tower for Borgen. Oh, great. Well, there's the levitating slob himself. Since Borgen has the power of the Black Dragon, he's become invincible, I think. There's only two people that have more power than he. Althina and Galleon. With the power of the Black Dragon, Borgen will never be defeated. He's definitely become the best magician in the world. Halt! Wait! Aren't you... Yes, yes, we met in vain. Don't you remember me? You must remember me. I was walking around and we made eye contact. I even said hi to you. Come on, you must remember me. You know, you can't keep running away from me. I know we met. Just admit that you saw me. That's all I ask. Who the hell? Why? Borgen is the most powerful wizard that's ever existed. He's created an entirely new magic city that is far better than Vayne. We are already preparing to recognize Borgen as the new leader of the Magic Guild. Lord Borgen is the rightful leader of the Magic Guild. He's more interested in Vayne than that money-grubbing Lamina. Even though Borgen is as ugly as a festering boil, Lady Miria has fallen in love with him. No, she has not. Honestly, I don't know how she does it. You are severely misinformed. Well, well, Borgen says, if it isn't my dear Lamina. You're the last person I would have expected to see in Pentagulia. Shut up, you overweight toad. I'm tired of listening to your trite speeches. I have two reasons for being here. The first is to rescue my mother. And the second is to make sure that you never again set foot in Vayne. Alright, that's it. Let's get to that one last tower. Oh yeah. I think I'm gonna go sleepy after this. The Red Priest Mari. Lord Leo and Lady Mari have devoted their lives to further Althina's cause. But ever since Lord Leo was granted the destiny, he never sees Mari anymore. Have you noticed that even when Mari smiles, you can see the pain in her eyes? In the past, she used to be so carefree, but now she's just so empty. Lord Mari hasn't been herself lately. It seems that she's being haunted by strange dreams during the night. She keeps saying that it feels as if she's dying inside. I'm worried. Rumor has it that Lady Mari has been granted the power of the Red Dragon. That's why she can throw fire at will. Ha! That's nothing compared to what I can do. Okay, so I guess we're gonna listen at this door. My dear Reinfar, why have you come all this way to see me? There's nothing left to discuss. Our love has grown cold. Oh, Mari, don't say that. I've been running from my true self. I realized some things when I last saw you. I realize that I can't live without you, that I need you in my life. But we have to find a way to free you from this evil spell you're under. But Ronfar, I am this way because of you. Don't you see? We can never go back. How sad. Okay, so that's what our members or other members are up to. So stay tuned when we go into the Holy Sanctuary, where the goddess resides. Thanks for watching, see you next time, and a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.